10,000 years ago, we Night Elves defeated the Burning Legion. Though the rest of the world was shattered, we were left free to live out our immortal lives in peace. Bound to the World Tree, we are its protectors, and through it we were granted immortality and power over nature. Now, at last, it is time we gave that power back.
You realize that we will age as these mortals do. Our powers over nature will wane in time.
If pride gives us pause, my love, then perhaps we have lived long enough already. I will proceed to the summit and prepare our defenses there. Whatever comes, my love, remember, our bond is eternal.
Hello guys, this is Oran Smoovies, and today I got another World of Warcraft roleplaying guide. Now in this video, I will help you roleplay your Night Elf and also help you set everything up. So, as always, we'll go over the lore as the most important part of the video. However, I won't go into like crazy detail about it, and I will only give you like a shorter version so you get like the basic grasp of it. Now after that, I will give you a bit of an insight into their culture, their lifestyle, help you name your character, pick a personality and a class, and set everything up. So without further ado, let's just get into the lore. So the Night Elves are one of the only races in the game that have a lot of developed lore and also quite big roots in the entire Warcraft universe. Now their lore has changed quite a bit in the past few years, but nonetheless they still had a giant influence on the world of Azeroth as it is today. Now long ago the Titans created the Well of Eternity and a tribe of Tarak Trolls settled near it. Now over time the well made them evolve, turning them smarter, stronger, wiser and also immortal. Now they also grew taller and their skin changed a bit in color, and soon enough they called themselves the Kaldorei, meaning the Children of the Stars. Now they grew stronger and stronger as their presence was quite fearsome, and they also managed to fight off the trolls with great ease and claim a big part of the Kalimdor as their own. Now after some time they met the Great Cenarius and a lot of other powerful entities, and they were taught a lot of things that are highly respected in today's culture, such as keeping a balance of nature and respecting the living forests and all of that. Now their empire grew, and soon enough they had cities, roads, temples, and their knowledge of magic was also growing. Now Queen Ashara started to study the Well of Eternity, and soon enough they discovered the arcane magic, and even though Cenarius and many others warned her of the harm that can come, she and her highborn still kept expanding their powers. Now her use of magic worked as a lighthouse for Sargeras, well sort of in a metaphorical sense, the leader of the Burning Legion, and soon enough they came in contact and he convinced them to open a gateway to Azeroth, and since she was arrogant and power hungry and thought of everyone as less races, she gladly made a deal, and thus the War of the Ancients began. Now I won't go into too much detail here as there is an entire trilogy about these events, plus I also believe I made some videos about it, but in the end they banished the Burning Legion and the Sundering was upon the world of Azeroth. Now the Well of Eternity blew up, changing the map of the entire world, and most of Ashara's followers were dragged to the bottom of the sea and transformed into sea serpents known as the Naga. Now the scar of this event is still there and it is called the Maelstrom, in the middle of the map right now where the Well of Eternity once was. Now Illidan, after that, took some wilds from the original lake and poured 3 wilds into a lake in Hyjal, turning it up into pretty much a mini Well of Eternity, and he refused to give up magical powers, and for that he was imprisoned for 10,000 years by his brother Malfurion. Now soon enough, with the help of the Aspects, the Night Elves turned the lake into Nordrassil, the first world tree, and thus they became the protectors of it and gained their immortality. Now after this, there wasn't all too much lore, but there was those highborn that were exiled and became the High Elves, and also the entire Borgin Curse, but I already explained that before in previous videos and in the Bad Elf RP guide, so it isn't really all that relevant for this current video. Now after 10,000 years and the first invasion, the Burning Legion struck again, and thus the third war began. Now at first they were offended with the presence of the orcs who came to Ashenvale in order to gather wood, so they together with Cenarius fought them, but the orcs consumed the demon blood that Manaroth brought there in order to deceive the orcs, and together Grom Hellscream and the orcs defeated Cenarius. However, at the height of the conflict, when the Scourge attacked with full force and Archimonde leading them, they made their final defense with the help of the Wisps and the World Tree, and they tore Archimonde apart. Now, even though they were victorious, they did suffer greatly, and the World Tree Nordrassil has been destroyed, thus destroying their immortality as well. and their protection from aging, diseases, and all that stuff. However, they did create a new world tree called Teldrassil, and near it they also built their capital, Darnassus, but the Aspects refused to give it their blessing, as they did with Nordrassil. However, after the events of the Stormrage novel and the entire Emerald Nightmare thing, Ysera and Alexstrasza blessed it, restoring the nature's ancient bond with the Night Elves. Alright, that is all I have for the lore. Now, compared to other videos, in this one I cut the lore probably to the shortest, and in order to not complicate it and just give you a basic understanding of how the Night Elves started and how they got to where they are right now. But if you want to learn more about it, there are a lot of other sources for you, especially the books, as I made a video covering all of the Warcraft books to this date, with a brief description and everything, so you will have an annotation for that in the video if you want to check that out and see which books are there and what they're about. Now, let's get a bit of an insight into their culture and lifestyle. Now, the Night Elves are pretty much all about the nature, and their culture is also based around it, their lifestyle and everything. Now, they're much like the Tauren when it comes to druidism and respecting all living forms and just general peace in the world and balance. And they're also nocturnal, if that's any relevant, and most of the things they do at night. And that's where we see that most of their zones kind of are like darkish and all of that. Now, when it comes to the genders, they're quite unique compared to other races. I mean, before, strictly men were druids and most of the women were warriors, priestesses, etc. But recently, it has kind of loosened up. Although not fully, and there is not like full gender equality, but you can definitely see some female druids today, just as you can see some male priests and sentinels. Now, their aging is quite a question today, as they used to be immortal, but it's not entirely certain if they receive their immortality back. I don't think there is an official word about it, even though it is highly speculated that they have, since Teldrassil and all that, the blessings. But they only became mortal some 20 years ago, and a lot of them even noticed aging, diseases, and all sorts of issues that all the mortals face. And it isn't fully known how long, but the Night Elves, even when mortal, do live a lot longer than the humans, just like the High Elves lived for a few hundred years since they lost their immortality as well. Now, religion and faith is a big part of the Night Elven society, if not the biggest one, and universally, almost all of them believe in Ilun, and in one way or another, while they also revere the raw forces of nature and the ancients such as Goldrin, Cenarius, Aviana, and all of that. So if you're playing a Night Elf seriously, I would take into consideration that they're highly spiritual people. Now, when it comes to their appearance, even though they are descended from the trolls, they do look a bit different, although you can definitely see that they look kinda similar. I mean, their skin color is usually purplish color, if you could say that, and they're one of the tallest playable races out there, although not the tallest one. I believe that's the Tauren, but definitely bigger than the humans. And of course, as any fantasy elves, they have these long, sharp ears as well. Now, when it comes to naming your character, there aren't too many rules, but there are a lot of misconceptions, as a lot of people believe that Night Elves need letters like X or Z or J, but names containing some of those letters are actually pre-sundering, so 10,000 years ago, like Azshara, Xavius, Jared, and all of that. While today's names are kinda different, so names like Erelas, Iveron, Gerolas work fine for the males, while names like Direnia, Darin, and Nessa work good for the females. Alright, now let's get into their personalities. Now, as always, I will only give you some basic personalities that you should like use as a starting point to developing your character, but if you want to have more of a developed character, I would suggest taking some time to figure out a good backstory and kind of tie your personality with it, as a lot of personalities are related to the backstories, and if you have a well-developed backstory, it will work quite well for you. Alright, the first one is the peaceful one. Now, this one is the recognizable one, and many Night Elves are like this. They respect all forms of life and the nature and look towards the greater peace and balance. They also don't like to hold grudges, although they still can, and they try to look for the best in everything. Now, usually this personality is also wise and thinks things through and makes the right decisions. So this is a really good personality for a Night Elf if you want to be sort of a hippie, as a lot of people call the Night Elves. Now, the next one is the neutral. Now, this one is closely tied to the first one, although not as hippie, if you could say that, and not everything is about peace for them. Now, a lot of Night Elves are like this, so you can be good-hearted but also ready to fight for what is yours, while still holding great respect for the nature and all living forms, and pretty much trying to keep the balance. Now, we don't necessarily have to be good, because not all Night Elves are like these angels and all of that. I mean, there are a lot of evil Night Elves. although with this sort of attitude, it is advised to be good. Alright, and the last personality type is the arrogant one. Now, this one is most relatable to the Highborn, and it's the best to roleplay as one, although be careful as the Highborn are kind of very rare these days. Although, you don't have to be a Highborn, as pretty much everyone can be arrogant, I guess. Now, you can go about this one in a few ways. You can either be one of the regular Night Elves, just kind of self-centered and arrogant, douchey, I guess, and just completely not care about anything or any sort of balance. Although, be careful, as many Night Elves were exiled because of this sort of behavior. Now, that is all there is for these personalities. As I said, these are kind of just guideline personalities. And if you want to hear a well-developed character, I would suggest taking some time and figuring out a good backstory and pretty much everything in detail. Although, as I said, you can also be evil or do whatever you want. These are kind of just like stereotypical personalities, I guess. It's not all Night Elves are like these super angels and all of that. And lastly, before I end the video, let's get into the classes. Now, as always, I will only cover a few in order to make the video to a decent length and pretty much keep everything consistent with the previous videos. But if you want to learn more, you still have the other sources, and as I said in the videos, I will make a Death Knight guide for all the races after I finish these race guides. So as always, let's start out with a warrior. Now, warriors, as usual, are nothing really super mystical, and are a pretty straightforward class, but as always, you can go about it in many ways. So you can either be like a regular guard or a warrior using a sword, although you can still be a sentinel, which is pretty much an elite order. And he has multiple divisions, one with the archers, the huntresses, which are mounted, and also the hippogriff riders, although many of these are kind of shared with the hunter class. Alright, and as I mentioned, the next one is the hunter. Now, hunters are a great choice for the Night Elves, even though some people might not agree on that, since hunters do in a way kind of destroy the nature, kill the animals, and all that, but their approach to hunting is kind of similar to the Tauren, with respect. And also, since they are so close to the nature, they're also great trackers and pretty much know every part of their woods and get used to any forested areas pretty quickly. So you can do multiple things with this class, although, as I mentioned in the first one, you can also try the huntress or just a regular archer or even a flying archer with a hippogriff and all of that. Although, due to game mechanics, that might not work that great. Alright, next one, and probably the most important one, is the druid. Now, this one is probably the closest to the Night Elves in their culture, and many of the Night Elves are druids, and druids are generally highly respected in their society, so you can choose your affiliation, but the main part is that you respect the nature and rely on it, while you also help the nature in return. Now, all in all, I think this is a great class to pick as a Night Elf, and probably the most recognizable one, as it is kind of a signature race for the Night Elves. Alright, and the last class I'm going to cover is the mage. Now, the mages are very problematic in the Night Elven society, as they always avoided arcane magics because of what happened to them 10,000 years ago, and pretty much how it led to so much destruction. But since the remaining Highborn joined the Night Elves in Cataclysm, they started learning more of it, although still being careful about arcane magics. So you can either be a Highborn, although as I said, they're quite rare these days, so do be careful on that. Or just be one of the trainees of them since Cataclysm, since they joined the Night Elves officially. Alright, and that is all there is for the classes. As I said, I haven't covered all of them in order to keep the video to a decent length, although I will cover some classes that I haven't covered in these race guides once I finish this race series. For example, I will cover the classes like the Death Knights, or maybe even the Monks, although I'm not really sure at this point. Alright, and that is all I have for this guide. Thanks so much for watching, and do give me some feedback on what you think, and which race you would like to see covered next, as I only have a few to cover until I finish this entire race RP guide series. Also, do give some feedback on the channel and what you would like to see generally on the channel as well. And don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe, as it really helps out these videos and the channel and pretty much keeps everything going. And also check out my Twitch.tv stream, as I stream there a few times a week. I also do giveaways, playing with viewers, and you can also ask me all sorts of like lore questions or RP questions that I might not have answered before. Anyway, thanks so much for taking your time to watch this video, and see you next time.